I'm a SEBI registered research analyst. I have been in stock market for last 25 years. And in this video, we'll be talking about fintech, you know, what's the future of fintech and will I be investing in them? I would really look for a stock in fintech segment, which is complying to all the government rules and regulations. There are four or five companies that have filtered up because these are two favorite fintechs of mine. Definitely, these new age companies have a lot of potential to grow. And invest in a staggered. You don't need to invest entire capital in one. Any of these can be downloaded anytime. If a better company comes up, if a better technology comes up, the other we become redundant. So we need to be updated. I have published about 5,000 research papers on selecting stocks.
Stock trading involves inherent risks. You are solely responsible for your investment decisions and any resulting outcomes, including financial loss. This video is for educational purposes only and does not constitute financial advice. The information presented reflects expert views and should not be considered a recommendation to buy or sell any security. References to specific stocks or mutual funds are for illustrative purposes only. Investing carries risk. Always consult a professional financial advisor before making investment decisions.
I'm Dr. Seema Jain. I'm a PhD in physics from IIT Delhi. And I'm a SEBI registered research analyst. Very few ladies in India are SEBI registered, and I'm one of them. And I have been in stock market for the last 20 years, and that was almost like similar amount of years I've spent in educating children. And I have published about 5,000 research papers on selecting stocks and finding out multi-baggers in their very, very initial days. And I have published about 2,000 YouTube videos. And in this video, we'll be talking about fintech, you know, what's the future of fintech and will I be investing in them? How will I find, you know, what kind of fintech I like? All of it we'll be discussing in this particular video. So in the fintech sector, what they really look into is they should be majorly not really debt driven, and they should be, you know, complying to all the policies. So if they are not complying to the policies, then there is a possibility later on they may falter. And they're like, for example, Paytm, if you take, they haven't complied to all the policies, government. So then hence the stock just tanked. So I would really look for a stock in fintech segment which is complying to all the government rules and regulations. That's one very good thing for me. And then of course the borrowings has to be leased, and I feel that the fintech sector is really bright. You know, for India, I have checked all the 3-4 companies that are there. They're really bright. I really feel that if they are complying to all the rules, I definitely would like to be for it. So majorly, there are 4 or 5 companies that are filtered out. Like one is Zaggle, the other is Policy Bazaar, then MOS, and then there's one Infinity. These are the 4 companies that I majorly track, and out of them, I think Zaggle really looks good to me. And PB Fintech, you know, PB Fintech is a company which is basically Policy Bazaar, Paisa Bazaar, etc. And I like their module. They've been really doing well, and the FIs are continuously increasing their stake in this particular company. So PB Fintech right now, actually I have given a buy way earlier in this particular company, and right now also it stands on a position where it is again ready to give another about 10 to 15%. Its fundamentals being really strong and becoming stronger day by day. And the other one that I really find good at this point of time is Zaggle. Zaggle is again a fintech company, and they are into, you know, a lot of, I'll just tell you what all they work. They work into the accounts management services, help employees save tax and sales, flexible employee benefit plans, and the all-in-one solution to employee rewards and channel partner incentives. So they are actually offer combination of payment instruments, mobile application and API integration through Visa cards, mobile app partners and dashboard. So I really like these kind of companies, you know, where taking their services is a compulsion. For example, if you ask me internationally, I love Visa card and the MasterCard because these are 2 favorite fintechs of mine. Once you make the infrastructure, people just have to go through, like, even if you have a HDFC credit card, or if you, even if you have any bank's credit card, either it will be Visa card or the Master. Once, you know, like you are using a credit card, it has to be either major. I'm not saying entire space, but majorly it's like. So I like these services where it's compulsion to take these services. So Zaggle is very promising, and definitely PB FinTech, these are two which are really fine, and out of them, Zaggle definitely looks very promising. At this point of time, because it's little corrected. And if you really look into the Zaggle's client, they're basically like Tata Capital, NSDL, DBMS, Wockhardt, Yes Bank, Reply. So all these, you know, they have collaboration with them. I believe they have a great future lying ahead, and stock is corrected. You know, that's a very important for me to take an entry, because it's around 311 rupees today as it closed. And I think the journey towards 400 has started. So, see, definitely these new age companies have a lot of potential to grow, because they have cracked some very, very new ideas. But again, as we have seen, you know, how delivery tag today or yesterday, how Paytm tag today and yesterday, it's been going down, you know, for quite some time. What I would suggest, that always monitor your position size and invest in a stagger. You don't need to invest entire capital in one go. So your capital has to be staggered. Every dip should be an opportunity for the fundamentals. For example, PB FinTech, or for example, Zaggle. So every time stock corrects about 15 to 20%, we can invest more. Or you can take some technical indicator if you're using that. But this is how we can mitigate the risk, you know. But of course, there is a risk assigned with all these FinTech stocks and new age stocks, because the future is unpredictable. You know, we can't predict what may lie ahead. For example, nobody ever knew that Paytm may have this kind of a fate. So one has to be very careful and diversify. Just don't put all your money in FinTech, some part of in FinTech, so that you enjoy the growth. And you never know, it may become multi-bagger over 10 years or something. But what I also understand, that technology really changes very fast. The way mobile phone change, the way laptop change, same way technology changes. So suppose there is a FinTech right now in the form of Zaggle, and something better comes up tomorrow, then Zaggle will have no value. So you have to stagger, and you have to have the parameters in place to exit. You know, like exit is also very important in FinTech. So keep rotating your capital, and I would say don't remain invested for a very long time, because technology really changes fast. So we need to keep that also in mind. Something better comes up, this stock will have no value. So with that, you know, we have to keep our position sizing very, very restricted, and keep rotating and have parameters in place to know now the top has been formed, or some new product is coming up. So we need to be very aware in this particular field if we are investing huge. Technology itself is changing rapidly. You know, now AI is coming up, and then there are many other latest tools coming. So the technology, all these fintechs, all these, like, for example, you've seen how Byju's have been down and out. Similarly, any of these can be down and out anytime. If a better company comes up, if a better technology comes up, the other will become rid of. So we need to be updated. That's the way we can mitigate our risk and reduce our capital invested in a particular FinTech stock. So one is that you diversify in different companies, keep small position sizing, keep a technical setup in place, and be informed about the market, so that if something better is in the process of developing, or you get to know about it, you better take some preventive steps. I'm very, very optimistic on the story called India. And I'm really optimistic on India's youth, their capabilities, their ability to create something out of the box. So I'm very positive on India's FinTech story. And I keep investing in every FinTech. Like all of these stocks, like Zaggle, if you see, I have a dedicated video on YouTube on PB FinTech, or you talk about Infibeam, I've made dedicated videos on all of them. So I'm pretty optimistic in India. I'm pretty optimistic on the youth of India, and I'm pretty optimistic on the policies that are given to startups. So new startups will keep coming and new companies will keep coming and they will keep flourishing. And I would like to ride this new age wave with the youngsters. So I'm pretty positive. And I would say that if you find a good company, you must invest in it and you must encourage the youth. If we trust our youngsters and their ideas, then only the country. So I am very positive. And I will keep investing. Yeah, for sure. I'll be keep investing and suggesting. But right now, my bet is on Zradan. Zradan is really a must. And there's one part of the question which is still left. What trends do you see emerging? I see very strong build-ups happening in this particular area. And more fintech companies are going to come in this space because India has a huge, huge bank of youthful brain who are working on rapidly developing new technology. So I would definitely be liking, I would be the part of all the fintech developments that take place. But of course, again, my rules will remain same, that I will diversify, I won't put all the capital, and I will keep watching the rules and regulation in that particular space. In case there is something, you know, some company not following rules and regulation, then definitely I will not go for it. Yeah. So I'll be signing off with this. And again, fintech, I believe in the story called India, and I believe in the Indian youth and their ability to create something very new. And I will be investing in all the fintechs that are coming here.